to tell you about the greatest love ever. That is the love that God has for mankind. Yes, I'm talking about the greatest love story ever. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. In the Bible, in John chapter 3 verse 16, so this is the verse given. So let's think about this simple verse. For God so loved the world. God just felt like loving the world. You know, the world includes you and me. Not only that, it includes the 7.8 billion people who live in the 200 odd nations of planet Earth. They live in 7 continents. They speak different languages. Maybe sometimes they follow different religions. But whatsoever, God loves each one of them. That is the love of God. So what is the difference between man's love and God's love? Well, man, we have a nature of loving people who love us back. And we also have a nature of hating people who hate us. So that is how man loves. Man can love another person for a season and then stop loving him. Maybe man also loves people for benefits. If it's beneficial to us, we continue to love them, or else we turn an enemy against them. But look at this, God so loved the world. When there are several kinds of love, like philios, eros, then agape. So I'm talking about the God kind of love, the agape kind of love. It is incomprehensible. Words cannot describe it. Look at this. God, he created mankind. But the same mankind rebelled against God. They did not follow his commandments. Whatever we do against the will of God is sin. So, according to God's rule, a price had to be paid. No man was pure enough to pay that price. So God himself, for God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, is Jesus Christ. He came to this earth. He was born of Virgin Mary. He lived for 33 and a half years. He lived an ordinary life till the age of 30. Then when his public ministry started, he started displaying the love of God. Wherever he went, he healed them all. Whenever he saw the sick, the love and compassion flowed out of Jesus. He healed them. The blind, they received sight. The deaf, they began to hear. The mute, they began to speak. The crippled and the lame, they walked. The paralyzed, they took their beds and walked. Look at this. These are all difficult things for man. There is a limit to the things that man can perform in this world. But God so loved the world. Wherever God saw a need, he intervened. When Jesus, he went to the wedding at Cana, there was a lack. There was a definite lack. The wine got exhausted. The family was in shame. But there, Jesus intervened. He turned water into wine. That is the kind of God we serve. Maybe in your life you're also going through a similar situation. Maybe you do not have a hope in your life. The good news is that there is hope in Jesus. Maybe you're saying that my problems are too big. Don't worry, the solution is Jesus Christ. Maybe you have so many questions, maybe unanswered questions. You're wondering who is going to answer it. For every question, the universal answer is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Maybe there is nobody in the world to love you, but do not worry. There is a God who saw it fit to love you in spite of your sins, in spite of your rebellious nature, in spite of all your faults. God so loved the world. My dear friends, you will not perish if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You will have an everlasting life. This is the good news we preach. My dear friends, it is fortunate, or by divine providence, that you have all heard the good news message or the gospel. So that is why you have a surety that you have an everlasting life. But are you ready to proclaim the love of Jesus Christ to whomsoever you meet? Maybe you might say that I don't have a pulpit. You might say that maybe I don't have an opportunity. Think of it, my dear friend. Jesus Christ, before he went to heaven, he gave the great commission. He told the disciples and everyone to preach the gospel to every creature, to preach the gospel to the uttermost parts of the world. You have a part in this great commission. You might think that you are an ordinary person, but don't underestimate yourself. God is with you. You have Christ on your front. You have Christ behind you. You have Christ on your right. You have Christ on your left. You have Christ above you and Christ beneath you. You have Christ within you. With God, you are not a minority. You are a majority. The love of God should flow through you, should flow through your hands. The Bible says, lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Do you believe it? Do you have the faith? Yes, when you proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, whatever you say, God will attest it with signs, wonders and miracles, proving that He is the one true God. Look at this. People right now all over the world, they are in fear. Why is it? Because it is because of an invisible enemy. And the enemy is called coronavirus. Nobody can see a virus. A virus can be seen with ultra-powered electron microscopes. But the ordinary people, they haven't seen this enemy. But the name of it causes fear in them. Because most of the people, they don't know what will happen the moment they die. They have no surety about eternal life. They don't know a savior. My dear friends, it is your duty to preach the gospel. Wherever you can, in whatever way you can, give your life to Jesus. At the cross of Calvary 2000 years ago, Jesus became a living sacrifice. He shed his precious blood at the cross for the redemption of your sins. Yes, you are healed in the name of Jesus. By his stripes, you were healed. Maybe if you're sick, accept the healing in the name of Jesus. I'm talking about the name that is higher than any other name. The name that is higher than any disease. A name that is higher than any circumstance. You're talking about love. I'm talking about the love that God exhibited. In spite of our iniquities, God still loves us. He is a God of second chances. Yes, right now, even now, God is willing to accept you. Maybe you all are born again and have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, but you have a bounden duty to preach the gospel to every creature. Maybe when you open, maybe in the morning when you wake up, maybe somebody will be there to deliver milk to your home. Maybe there'll be a newspaper boy. Have you ever shared the gospel to him? Maybe when you go to an office or where in your workplace, you are the evangelist in that place. If you open your mouth for Jesus, definitely you can win souls. One who wins souls is wise. Are you wise? You might say that, I just want a trouble-free life. I just want to continue living without any problems. Okay, that is fine. But ultimately, there is a big harvest in front of you. Are you aware of it? Are you utilizing your skills for the propagation of God's word? You do not need a pulpit. If you are pulled from the pit, yes, you are definitely qualified to proclaim Jesus. If you can just say that Jesus loves you, that is enough. You need not be a theologian. You need not be a Bible scholar. There are so many people in the world who still do not know about the first coming of Jesus. Yes, it might seem shocking, but that is the reality. Who will go out and preach? You might say that, yes, I understand that God loves us. Yes, I am safe, but I don't care about others. Then even you might say that I'm giving my offerings and tithes to the pastor, to the churches, and let them go out and preach. You might even say, Lord, send my pastor. But I want to say you, God wants you. You might say that I'm not qualified, but He calls and that qualifies the called. You are all called to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is high time that you proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. When you look in John chapter 9 in verse 4, it reads something like this. I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. Did you get this point? John chapter 9 verse 4. I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. Can you just rewind maybe 2 months? Maybe think about January end. You still had the liberty to go anywhere in the world. You had the liberty to travel to any corner of the world. Of course, you needed some money, you had a passport and a flight ticket. But now, all aeroplanes are grounded. You can't do it anymore. Then all of you are locked down. There was a time when you could go to your churches, you could worship God, you could preach the gospel. There was a time when you could move around freely. There was a dead time. Did you use it wisely? No. You can say that it is a darkness. You are confined to your homes. You are virtually locked down. Only you understand the value of brightness or light only when you go through a dark situation. Now when you look behind, you will surely understand that you had a chance to win souls. You had an opportunity to do a lot for Jesus Christ. My dear friend, after this lockdown is over, are you ready to propagate the love of Jesus Christ? Are you ready to share his gospel? Are you ready to heal the sick? Are you ready to preach the good news of Jesus Christ? Who will preach about heaven and earth? Who will preach about eternal life and eternal condemnation? Who will preach about the word of God? Who will preach about a savior? Who will preach about a healer? Who will preach about Jesus Christ? You are the people that God has chosen. This is the good news that I have for you. You might say that nobody invites me. Maybe you might say that my pastor does not think that I can preach. Don't worry, you have a mobile phone. Use whatever you have. Well, when you look at Moses, God asked him what he had. He told, I just have a rod. God used that to divide the Red Sea. He used that symbol rod to turn it into a snake and threaten Pharaoh the king. Now, what do you have? You might have a mobile phone. Just take it, flip it on the camera, record a message. Just say, Jesus loves you. You have maybe 5,000 friends on your Facebook. You have so many friends on maybe Instagram or Twitter or whatever social media platform or YouTube. Use your time wisely. Propagate the good news of Jesus Christ. People are dying on a daily basis. When you look at worldometer, you can see the number of people who are dying because of this epidemic. I think more than 20 lakh odd people are affected by this disease. And a huge, maybe 1.4 lakh people have already died. Did they all hear the good news? Or did they heed the word of God? Maybe they all had a chance to receive and accept Jesus Christ as a Lord and Savior. How many of them did it? Whatever it is, we do not know what tomorrow holds. So whatever time you have, be faithful in. Be faithful in little things. When you're faithful in little things, God sees it and he will take you to places. He will honor you. Right now, I would like to appreciate you. You are using this small app and you are propagating the gospel. Do not worry if there are 4 people or 5 people. If two or three people are gathered in my name, I am there in their midst. God is here. He is listening to us. He is happy that you have given your time for God. Every person in this world has 24 hours. Even Bill Gates has 24 hours. Even Donald Trump has 24 hours. Even you have 24 hours. The richest and the poorest. The rich, the poor, the educated, the uneducated. Everybody has one resource, one capital, that is time. You have time on your hands. Are you using it to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ? Use whatever means you have. Maybe you have a talent to sing. Yes, worship God, sing songs and declare the works of God. Do not fear, you will all live long and declare the works of the Lord. Use your time wisely. I'll tell you, There, everybody in this world, they are born on a particular day. That is the birthday. You will rejoice over it. You will be happy that you have a birthday. Every year you thank God that, yeah, this is my birthday. You will be happy. But everybody must know that there is also a death day. You do not know when it will come. Maybe it's tomorrow. Maybe it's after 100 years. We don't know. Whatever it is. You have a finite time. If a person lives on this earth for 100 years, he has a maximum of around 36,500 hours. Oh, sorry, days. 36,500 days to live on this earth. Are you using it for God? Maybe right now when you look at your age, you know that you have spent a lot of time. Some of them you have wasted. Half of it you have slept. Half of the time you have watched TV. Half of the time you spoke to people about irrelevant things. A time will come in your life when you will know, I could have done better. We do not want a situation where you will be regretting. Do not regret. So use your time wisely. Use the time to preach the gospel about the love of Jesus Christ. If you don't preach, who will preach? If you don't go, who will go? My dear friend, one who wins souls is wise. We all like to talk about the love of God, but are you ready to take a risk for God? God loves you, fine. You also love God, but how much do you love God? Look at the life of Abraham. He blindly followed God. Right now, when we say to you that you must go to a particular place, first you take the map, you find the Google address, then you see which mode of transportation you could use. And if everything is fine, then you go. In those days, God asked Abraham to go to a place, to an unknown place. It did not have a name. There was no GPS. He did not know how long it will take. He did not know how arduous the journey would be. But still, he blindly followed. Look at this. Are you ready to preach the gospel in these times? Are you ready to go to places wherever God tells you? Now look at the case of Job. You might say that you can testify only in good times. No, he was going through all kinds of trouble in his life. Suddenly he lost his children. He lost whatever wealth he had. He became a sick person. Even his wife told, you should better reject God. But look at his response. His love for God was so much. Did he leave God? Absolutely no. In your good times and in your bad times, you should worship God, praise Him, have your hope in God. Now look at the case of Daniel. He was a praying man. He had a habit of praying. So he obeyed God's commandment. He was not willing to bow before the idol because he loved his God. He loved the commandments of God. There was a high risk. The people who hated him, they conspired to put him in the lion's den. It was certain death. Are you willing to take that extreme step for God? Are you willing to risk your own life to preach about the love of God? If you are faithful with God, look at how God rescued Daniel from the lion's den. He fasted and prayed. So God declared a fasting prayer to the lion, to the hungry lions. God can do a miracle anywhere. He can do a miracle in that lion's den. Maybe you are telling that in your life there are so many problems. It cannot be salvaged. I tell you, whatever be the problem, whatever be the circumstances, whatever be the situation, God can do a miracle right now. Today you sanctify yourself. Tomorrow you will see a miracle. The God we serve is the God of now. You might say that my problem is impossible. Yes, it might be impossible to man, but the God we serve, He is the master of impossibilities. Whatever be the impossible situation in your life, right now in the name of Jesus, let it become possible. You can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens you. My dear friend, everybody in the world has their own issues of life. Right now you might not be in a lion's den, but you are somewhere, but you have your own problems, and to you right now that might be a difficult thing. Do not worry. Fear not. Give your problems to Jesus. Cast your burdens to Jesus, because God loves you. The Bible says, call unto me and I will answer you. In Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3, it says that, call unto me and I will answer you. Does it say that, call unto me, I may answer you? I might think about answering you. No, it says, call unto me and I will answer you. Right now, this is the time that you call to God. Yes, call unto him and he will answer you. He will deliver you from whatever problem that you are going through. My dear friend, maybe you are going through a fiery furnace. Look at Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. They were in the fiery furnace, but God, he descended into that fiery furnace. They were not consumed by the fire, but they came out. Look at this. Maybe you're also going through a fiery situation in your life. Maybe you're not in a physical fire. Maybe you got trouble with mental, emotional and circumstantial problems. From whatever be the problem, Jesus is alive and well. Yes, he will deliver you from that problem. My dear friend, are you walking with God? You should walk with God. When you walk with God and you meditate the word of God, God will speak to you and he will guide you. He will direct your steps. Maybe you say that I do not have a way. Maybe you're telling that after my studies, what should I do? I do not know what to do, where to go and how to do. You also don't know who will help you. Yes, where does your help come from? Your help comes from the maker of heaven and earth. My dear friend, this message is for you. Yes, God will help you when you are in a helpless condition, when man cannot help you, maybe when doctors cannot help you, maybe teachers cannot help you, maybe your mentors cannot help you, maybe your own parents or friends cannot help you. There is somebody who still loves you. He loves you with an everlasting love. Jesus Christ, he loves you. He will deliver you from all your afflictions. My dear friend, this 40 days, are you spending your time in prayer and fasting? Are you praying to God? Are you spending time speaking in tongues and reading the word of God? Then definitely your life will change for the better. Because if you spend time with God, he will definitely bless you. He will change your life situations. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth and the life. He is the way, the truth and the life. He will make way straight. He will make a way there is no way. Maybe you want a better life. Yes, he will give you the best life that you never even imagined. Because he has ways. He can give you the best life. He also gives you eternal, everlasting life. Maybe some of you were seeking truth. Maybe you have found out that Jesus Christ is the truth. It is your bounden duty to proclaim this truth to the millions around you who still do not know about the truth, the one true God, Jesus Christ. I would like to say that all of you have a part in building the kingdom of God. All of you have a role. Yes, you can and you will make a difference. God has placed you in this earth in a particular place for a definite particular purpose. It is for you to recognize your purpose and do it. I tell you, if you utilize your time, think about the next 24 hours. How are you going to use that for the gospel? How are you going to use that for God? If you are faithful in little things, God will see it and he will surely bless you. So we are talking about love. We talked about man's love. It changes. We talked about God's love. It is unconditional love. We talked about God loving the world. That includes you and me. We talked about God loving us so much that he gave his only begotten son Jesus Christ for the redemption of your sins. We talked about, do you really love God? Just like the saints like Abraham, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego and Job and so many other people. They continue to love God blindly. They continue to live for God in spite of the trouble, the circumstances and the risk to their own lives. Are you an armchair Christian? Are you sitting in your chair, relaxed in an armchair? Rise up. Rise up, my dear friend. It is time for you to preach the gospel, proclaim the gospel to the uttermost parts of the world. The world is waiting for a solution. The world is waiting for an answer. Well, people in the Western world, you might think that they had a good life. They had a good country. They had good countries, maybe cold climate. They had their homes. They had social security. They had the powerful government. They had all benefits. They had everything, but still, they did not know about God. They rejected God. They thought they're scientists. They are so brilliant. They could help them. Maybe still now, the scientists, they haven't succeeded in finding a vaccine for this coronavirus. So science has failed them now. Maybe they thought that we have the best doctors. Yes, the doctors, they are trying their very best. But what to do when they do not have a cure? Well, right now, the only hope is Jesus Christ. Now the message, Jesus heals you, is ever relevant. Now the message, Jesus saves you, is very relevant. Because now they need a savior. Moses, Noah, he preached for a long number of years, saying that something called rain is going to come. So repent. So I have built an ark, come enter it. Well, the people, they did not see rain. But when that invisible rain, the invisible enemy came, God closed the ark. They couldn't enter into it. Well, they all perished in that flood that lasted 40 days. Now Jesus Christ is your ark. Salvation is in Jesus Christ. Eternal life is in Jesus Christ. Now when you stand out and preach like a madman to the masses, maybe all these years they would have mocked you, saying that, hey, nothing will happen to me. No virus or no enemy can kill me. I will live long. I will live a happy life. But now, look at this. The kinds of number of people who are dying on a daily basis. Some were healthy, some were old, some were frail, some were rich. Look at this. Prime ministers and presidents, they are not immune to this. The rich are not immune. Celebrities are not immune. Look at this. Just in those days, there was the rain. Now, a different enemy, Corona, which is also invisible. Look at this. Now, they all have fear. The message is fear not. If you have Jesus Christ within you, you will not fear, because you know that you have a God who has assured you eternal life. You will live long and declare the works of the Lord. Even if you die, you know that you have a master waiting to receive you in heaven. My dear friends, are you ready to preach the good news? Because this is the opportune time. Look at this. The harvest is plenty. Yes, we are praying for laborers. You are those special people who are called to do the harvesting. Are you ready? Proclaim the love of Jesus. Jesus loves you. Whatever be the problem that you are going through, right now in the name of Jesus, I cancel it. Maybe whatever sickness you are going through, you be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. As a child of the Most High God, I take authority and I break anything that comes against you. I declare good tidings. I declare good news to you. I declare, let the impossible become possible in your life. Whatever failure you had, let that same thing be turned into success in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever impossibilities you had, Jesus Christ, I pray that He will turn that into possibilities. Yes, my dear friend, whatever be the problem that is crushing you, you will surely come out of it. You will come out victoriously. You will not die. You will not perish. You will live long and declare the works of the Lord. Fear not. Jesus loves you.